Hello, I'm Sharon Albert, Director of the Mission Trails Regional Occupational Program. The program you're about to see is a production of the Mission Trails Digital Media Network. This production features local students engaged in the California State Career Technical Education pathway, arts, media, and entertainment. A special thanks to the Media Center for Art, Education, and Technology, a department of the Monterey County Office of Education, for making this broadcast possible. Thank you for watching. Now let's enjoy the show.
Shall we begin?
Let's begin.
Welcome back to another episode of Trojan Weekly. My name is Victoria Gomez.
And I'm Irene Vidales. I'm filling in for Diana Mexicano today. It's been almost 3 years since Malaysia flight MH370 disappeared, and the underwater search hoping to locate remains of the plane has been canceled. The plane disappeared under mysterious circumstances of March 8, 2014, when the flight vanished from radar shortly after it took off from Kuala Lumpur.
It was suspected that the plane crashed somewhere in the Indian Ocean after parts of the plane washed up on shore. The crash claimed 239 lives of passengers and crew on board. Despite efforts on using cutting-edge technology over the last 2 years, Australian authorities have concluded that it would be best to suspend the search. This was announced 6 weeks away from the 3-year anniversary of the disappearance of the plane.
China will spend $2.6 million to fight air pollution in 2017. This year, Beijing will start an air pollution treatment to replace everything with clean energy. This will phase out 300,000 old vehicles and factories that will either be closed or upgraded. China will also restrict the amount of cars entering China.
A large gator estimated to be as long as an SUV has been found in Florida, roaming around Polk County area. The video of the gator, given the name Humpback by its fans, has gone viral all over social media. The park where the gator roams is a quiet place, but now that it's become famous, the park has become a tourist attraction. Authorities are now worried the gator's fame could put it in danger. The gator will have to be killed if it threatens the safety of those who go out to see it.
The U.S. recently deployed thousands of troops and some 2,800 tanks along with other weapons with machinery. They were sent to Germany and will be spread throughout Eastern Europe in order to stop Russian expansion.
Earlier this week, U.S. troops arrived in Poland where the Prime Minister gladly welcomed them. According to CNN 10, a United States commander said that the presence is solid evidence of the United States' continuous commitment to Poland and the NATO alliance.
Former U.S. President Barack Obama, before he left office, commuted to sentence the Chelsea Manning who leaked documents to WikiLeaks in 2010. Chelsea Manning is a transgender woman who was in the U.S. military and went by the name of Bradley Manning. Some of the Manning's leaked footage included the killing of civilians during a covert operation. Many were upset by the decision. Senator John McCain said she will get released in a couple of months, but her dishonor will last forever. Chelsea was sentenced for 35 years. The communication does not grant Manning innocence. It releases her from time served.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Donald John Trump, do solemnly swear.
I, Donald John Trump, do solemnly swear
that I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
The office of President of the United States.
And will, to the best of my ability, preserve, protect, and defend. The Constitution of the United States. So help me God. Congratulations, Mr. President.
Our newest president, Donald Trump, was inaugurated January 20th, marking the 58th inauguration ceremony. Trump was sworn in at the west front of the U.S. Capitol building. President Trump is now the 45th president and will serve for the next 4 years. The ceremony was heavily supported by those for Trump and protested by those who oppose. A good number of Americans across the nation protested the inauguration, with most of it being peaceful. Some of it did turn violent as protesters attacked businesses and tossed trash in the streets, which forced the police to resort to using tear gas. President Trump stated in his speech, "We are transferring the power from Washington, D.C. to you, the people." Trump heavily mentioned the people in his speech. Alisal High School's Dream Academy, a local nonprofit organization, sent students to Washington, D.C. to witness the historical inauguration firsthand. We have some interviews on their take of the inauguration.
Hi, my name is Ruben Pizarro. I'm a government teacher here at Alisal High School, and I was asked to talk about the inauguration, the recent trip that 100 Dream Academy students took to Washington, D.C. To take part in the inauguration and also to take part in the Women's March. So let me start with the inauguration. It was really... we weren't sure what was going to happen in the inauguration, right? We had been there for a week before the inauguration, and some of the students had gotten ugly looks and stares and offensive comments, and we weren't sure what it was going to be like in the inauguration. So first of all, we voted, and 75 of the 100 students decided to go to the inauguration. So we take off that morning, we're walking through the streets, and we're seeing all these protest groups going up, demonstrating. And we finally get on the National Mall. We didn't make it there until about the end of his speech. But we heard the end of his speech. We're looking on one of the big monitors, listening to him. And we see that he meets with President Obama. And they, President Obama, Michelle Obama, get into a helicopter. And they fly off. The helicopter flies over our head. And almost at that exact moment, the students got incredibly emotional and started to tear up, and many started to cry. And they were, all these emotions came flooding to them. They were a bit, I think, in mourning because of the fact that Obama wasn't there anymore. And I think they were also very angry, shocked, thinking that a person like Donald Trump, who has shown himself to be a racist, sexist person, is now going to be their president. Some of our students are undocumented. A lot of them were feeling fearful, thinking of what immigration policies now President Trump was going to implement in the country that might affect them or their families. So there was a lot of emotions going on in their heads and their minds, and so that's what happened with them there. The next day, though, we go back to the National Mall, and now it's to be a part of the Women's March on D.C., and it was incredibly powerful. There were probably, in our estimation, I don't know, 4 or 5 times more people participating in the Women's March than participated in the inauguration, and we were happy to see that. The Women's March was a lot of things. It was a protest against Donald Trump and his policies and his rhetoric up to that point. And it was also, of course, advocating for women's rights, for the gay community, and also for people of color. And so our students who were there felt incredibly empowered to be surrounded with people who felt the same way they did, were upset and disillusioned with our new president, but also feeling like, okay, this happened to us. What do? Do we just sit back and feel sorry for ourselves? Or do we take action? Do we do what we can do to educate ourselves, to inform ourselves, to make sure that on the next election, when our students who are, you know, in high school now, many of them will now be able to vote. And we want to instill in them the importance of civic engagement and, of course, in voting in the next election so that they can get results that they're more happy with. So I think that's what I was asked to talk about, so that's about it. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Eric Gonzalez, and I recently went to the inauguration in Washington, D.C. I felt that the people around me felt as if the world was ending around them as we saw President Obama leave on that helicopter. We thought that our president's gone, or the only president that understood us was gone, and now we're going to start off with a new president that apparently does not like our culture or our people. He wants to build a wall to stop the rest of us Mexicans from coming over to the United States. And I feel as if that is not a good thing to do. I recently heard that he's actually signed papers to get start building his wall, and that's gonna cause a lot of problems. I'm not sure if people will get deported immediately or what's gonna happen with them, and that's something very scary.
Hello, my name is Gustavo Hernandez, and as many as have heard, I was at the inauguration this past Saturday, and honestly, I felt fine being there because I didn't let the idea of Donald Trump being our president get to my mind. And as I witnessed everyone, some people were devastated, some people were fine with it. There was a lot of anti-Trump supporters. Honestly, I felt great. I got to witness a historical event, and yeah, that's pretty much it.
Hola, mi nombre es Rubén Gómez. Y lo que pienso de la inauguración es que fue un evento muy grande a la que no asistieron muchas personas, ya que asistieron más personas a la marcha del día siguiente de las mujeres. Pero aún así fue un evento muy espectacular porque podías observar personas de las dos, unas que estaban a favor de Obama o en contra de Trump y las que estaban a favor de Trump. Fue una experiencia un poco triste porque vimos cuando se fue Obama y fue cuando todos o la mayoría nos dimos cuenta de que Trump iba a ser ya nuestro presidente. Como que nadie quería tanto Obama hasta ver que ya se había acabado su término presidencial. Y ojalá que Trump haga un buen trabajo como presidente, ya que es el presidente del país más importante o puede ser el más poderoso de todo el mundo. Y ojalá que pueda controlar al país y que no lo dejen hacer todas las cosas como contra los inmigrantes, porque los inmigrantes son los que más ayudan a este país y son los que hacen los trabajos que según los americanos no podrían hacer.
There has been plenty of protests going around in the nation, but the most covered and organized one was the Women's March on Washington. A group of strong and powerful women organized a unified march on Washington, January 21st. The march brought out over 2 million women who wanted to send a message to Trump, whose campaign was criticized for being against women.
Former U.S. President George H.W. Bush was hospitalized and diagnosed with pneumonia. His wife, Barbara Bush, is also in the hospital for bronchitis. Bush is currently recovering from his respiratory problems and is in stable condition. They will, however, remain under observation in the ICU.
The CIA database is now online, though information is, of course, limited to the classified documents. Historically, these documents were only accessible by taking a trip to the National Archives building in Maryland. You would have to use one of the 4 CIA computers available. The CIA published nearly 13 million declassified documents. These documents date from the 1940s to the 1990s.
According to CNN, the published documents include one pertaining to a UFO sighting and the agency's Stargate program. These documents also include those from the CIA's involvement during the Vietnam, Korean, and Cold War conflicts. Joseph Lambert, the CIA's longtime director of information management, said he wanted to make this happen before he retired.
Moving on to sports news, the NFL playoffs ended as the Green Bay Packers went up against the Atlanta Falcons. The Packers lost to 21-44, sending the Atlanta Falcons on the Super Bowl. Later that night, the Pittsburgh Steelers lost to the New England Patriots with the score of 17-36.
Super Bowl 51 will take place February 5th in Houston with the Atlanta Falcons taking on the New England Patriots. This year's halftime show will feature Lady Gaga performing.
In local news, on January 12th at approximately 9 p.m., a shooting took place in the 500 block of Sunrise Street of Salinas. The incident resulted in 2 deaths and 2 injured with non-life-threatening gunshot wounds. The deceased victims have been identified as Jose Luis Flores Vargas, age 27, and Alejandro Ramirez, age 25.
Early Wednesday morning, the Salinas police were involved in another shooting on the 600th block of Terrace Street. A 911 call was received around 1:30 in the morning about a suspicious man with a butcher knife who was described as acting erratically and swinging the knife around. Officers arrived in minutes, and a Salinas fire crew tried hosing him down but failed. 4 officers decided to use non-lethal bullets before resorting to tasers that were all ineffective.
The teenager, who was near the back of the property, ran inside the main house. Officers did not know if anyone was inside. And when teenager turned around and approached them, they used lethal force against him. The police are currently reviewing the footage and are trying to confirm all the information.
It was announced that Dungeness crabs will face a serious threat due to more acidity in the ocean. This would cause a significant decline in crab population in the next 50 years due to a loss of food caused by too much carbon dioxide in the atmosphere.
The chemical reaction will lead to acidic ocean water, which will impact the ecosystem. This is bad news for Dungeness crab fishers, who earn $220 million annually.
The Monterey City Council has voted to issue a permit for a professional baseball team to play at the Solicito Field. The team will be called the Monterey Amberjacks and will be one of the 12 teams that will play in the Pecos League out of Texas. The team was named after a fish and will play 16 games at Solicito Field. The games will be played Saturday and Sunday in order to not interfere with other activities that will take place on the field during the week. Fans can expect tickets to go on sale for about $10.
Some had concerns over the sale of beer along with the usual wear and tear. AstroTurf has been installed and the new field will have equipment to deal with noise and improve lighting. The baseball league will have to hire security for the stadium and team. The city believes money earned from the games will contribute to Monterey's economic recovery and revitalization. The season will begin May 26th and will run through July 27. Monday games will be played in Hollister.
Next is a tour of a local pet shop here in Salinas, California, called Jurassic Pets, located on 923 South Main Street. Here's a video tour of the shop and an interview with the store manager.
Thank you. Fernando. I work here at Jurassic Pets. I'm the store manager. We've been serving the Salinas area for 10 years. We specialize in reptiles, but we are a full-line pet store. So we do offer dog food, dog supplies, aquatic supplies, aquatic livestock, small animals, just to name a few. We started the store 10 years ago specializing in reptiles. So we are Monterey County's number one reptile store. We carry anything from bearded dragons, ball pythons as basics, all the way to the Australian skull dragons, to red-tailed boas, just to name a few animals. We are in 923 South Main Street. We do offer dog grooming. We do offer low-cost vaccinations for your dogs. So whenever you get a chance, stop by, visit us, and we'll be more than happy to help you with any of your needs.
For Alisal Sports News, girls basketball lost to Hollister with a score of 56-42. Boys basketball had two victories against Gilroy and Pajaro Valley. Boys soccer had a victory against Christopher with a score of 5-0.
In entertainment news, rapper 21 Savage has been climbing up in popularity in the past year. His dark, violent lyrics and whisper-like rapping bring a unique style and an approach towards hip-hop and the rap production. His career went mainstream when he was featured in the 2016 XXL freshman class. He then collaborated with producer Metro Boomin in the making of the album Savage Mode, in which two songs, Mo Heart and X, went platinum. With two platinum songs under his belt, he was recently signed with Epic Records. Fans are currently looking forward to Savage Mode 2.
Fashion brand Supreme released a picture of an upcoming collaboration with Louis Vuitton. Supreme, known for its streetwear, showed off its new red leather jacket, which is expected to drop July 17 at selected Louis Vuitton stores.
Daredevil is the story of Matt Murdock, a man who was blinded in a freak accident as a child, but was also gifted incredibly heightened senses. He then uses his skills and trains to become the man without fear, Daredevil. The show is pretty incredible with an amazing cast and story, along with some incredible action scenes that are sure to leave you speechless. By day, Matt protects the innocent as a lawyer, but at night, Daredevil protects the streets of Hell's Kitchen from ruthless criminal organizations and the mysterious ninja clan, The Hand. Catch Daredevil streaming now on Netflix.
Are left behind.
I don't see the city anymore.
Each breath you take is mine.
There's only dark corners.
I'll keep you safe, Karen. I have to be the man this city needs.
What are you gonna do?
Whatever it takes.
We fight every night for sun. When the sun sets, we're both the same.
You and I have a lot in common. We're nothing alike.
One match. Two match. Billion time. Father, why do I still feel guilty?
The guilt means your work is not yet finished.
Downtown office thinks we got a new player in Hell's Kitchen.
What do they want?
The DA's office says the shooter's independent.
He's tracking gangs to their home turf and taking them out with military precision.
With knowledge and hardware to take out half the city, Hell's Kitchen is about to explode.
Bang.
We created him. All of us.
There's no connection.
We never stopped to think that Daredevil's actions could open the door for men like this.
How
much longer before innocent people start getting caught in his crossfire?
Blood is being shed.
And you've donated more than your fair share.
The city needs him.
I need to take care of the scum that killed my family.
People don't have to die.
You hit them and they get back up. I hit them and they stay down. Why are you doing this?
Because I think you're a half measure. I think you're a man who can't finish the job. I think that you're a coward. You know, you're one bad day away from being me.
Miles Morales, the alternate dimension Spider-Man comic book character, is hitting the big screen with his own animated movie from Sony. The movie is expected to be released next year on December 21st, 2018. Miles Morales will bring more character diversity to Marvel, as Morales is part African American and Puerto Rican.
Three.
If you wanted me back.
A device that controls every military satellite in the world has fallen into the hands of four very dangerous guys.
We need someone who can move like them, fight like them. It's time to be a patriot.
There are no more patriots, just rebels and tyrants.
No rest.
The good, the extreme, and the...
Here we go. It's refreshing. You actually know what you're doing down there.
Yeah, that's what she said.
You have no idea what you're up against.
You ready to have some fun?
Thank you for watching another episode of Trojan Weekly. My name is Victoria Gomez.
And I'm Marine Vidales.
Go Trojans! There.
You got it. Okay.